Welcome back, fellow space engineers, to another, in this case, tutorial on the tutorial. Let's get started. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to click on a new game, scenarios, and learning to survive. And I know what you're thinking, but Kravec, that's a tutorial for space engineers. I know, but it turns out that the tutorial has a couple of flaws in it that new players might get hung up on. So we're gonna go through the tutorial in multiple parts, right? And answer these questions that new players might have, like, oh my god, it says grind or figure out how to unlock this landing gear. Well, we're going to figure out how to unlock it without grinding it down, because the tutorial doesn't tell you that. So, let's get started with that. All we're going to do is hit the start button right here. It doesn't take long for the game to load up, as you can see. And in addition to that, there's no mods. You can't mod the game. Alright? Well, you can. And if you want to know more about how to do that, leave a comment down in the description below. You can enable and disable good bot in-game help or control hints. And I'm going to show you real quick how to do that. If you hit the escape key and you go to options, click on game right here. You'll see it says show good bot hints. And you can set them up right here and then reset the hints. I normally leave this turned off, but you have to have it turned on for the tutorial. And then show control hints is right here. And basically what good bots will do is it will show, you know, what buttons to press and stuff like that. But it does it in that little box like we just saw in the upper left hand corner. All right, click cancel, escape out of that, and let's continue on with the tutorial. It's a little slow. All right. Hello, engineer. My name is Goodbot. I am the AI teacher that helps you by offering directions. Let's get you started. You can access useful information in the help screen. So we're going to press F1. That'll open up the help screen. The first thing you're going to see is all these tutorials right here. You can click on these links right here and open a browser outside the game. You got your basic controls, your advanced controls, your controller scheme if you use an Xbox controller. For PlayStation, I would assume that if you're on a PlayStation, this will change to what a PlayStation controller looks like. Then you have advanced controller functions. And you can see here, it just goes through and tells you, it's basically like the advanced controls, only this is for the controller. How to open chat and what the colors mean. Support links. The good bot log. So if you missed something up here, you can hit F1, go to the good bot log, and you can read it right here. And then a little welcoming letter from the creative director at King Software House. And then a way for you to report issues. And that is it that's in this menu. So we will hit back. And voila, the step is complete. We just have to wait on good AI. Changing your point of view can be useful in many situations. Toggle V to switch between first and third person point of view, and use Alt plus mouse wheel to adjust the distance of third person point of view. So we're already in third person, so we're going to hit Alt, and we're going to use that right there at mouse wheel, and voila, we can zoom in and out. The thing it doesn't tell you about Alt plus the mouse is if you hold down the Alt key, you can move the camera around your character. Or if you're in a ship, you can move your camera around the ship. That being said, it still locks onto the character more than the ship, right? You'll see that there's always a central point that it spins around, right? If you look at my cursor, it's on the front of the helmet right there. So it's always spinning around that one point. And then, if you're not holding Alt and you move the mouse, then you move your character like so. Let's press the V key and get this step completed. I like playing in first person point of view, so that's what we're going to play in. You will be built in no time. Third person camera will switch to first person if there are objects in your way. Basically, it'll force you into first person point of view for object collisions. Let's get you started on the basis of movement. Don't forget to stay on the ground. It's basic movement, like every other game. W, A, S, and D. Shift W will help you run. Hit the space bar to jump and C to crouch. Ta-da! Your jetpack runs on hydrogen fuel. Be careful not to run out of it while flying. So turn on the jetpack, you're going to hit the X key. Then you can use space and C to move up and down. W, A, S, and D to move forward, back, left, right. And two additional keys, Q and E, to roll left and right. There are small tasks for you to perform. These tasks can be activated by finding and activating specific button panels. There are several such button panels on this platform. Go try it out. Well, we could start anywhere, but let's start with the survival kit. We're going to run up to this button panel right here and come over here and click F. Oh, you can see it zapped me. So now I have 50% energy and 50% health. And it says the survival kit can produce small amounts of ingots from stone, produce basic components from ingots, allows you to recharge your energy as well as health, and allows you to respawn everything you need to get started. So we're going to come over here. We're going to point our cursor at this little highlighted screen right there. We're going to hit the F key. And if you look in the lower left-hand corner, you'll notice that both my health and my energy are rising back up. It does it slow, and I really don't like the noise. It's kind of annoying, but, you know, I wasn't the sound designer. Fantastic. Connect the H2O2 generator with a survival kit to recharge your hydrogen and oxygen as well. Turning off dampeners while flying allows you to move without slowing down. When you let go of the input, this can be useful to move steady at low or high speeds without using much fuel. All right, so to do that, I'm just going to show you here. I don't know why it did it on the Z, but whatever. Or on X when I turn on the... So that's what it's talking about. I'm steadily moving. I'm not using any fuel, but I turned off the dampeners and I'm steadily moving. If I turn them back on, I'll slow down. And then if there's an object that you're trying to move with, right? So let's say this ship was in motion right here. I could hit Control Z and my jetpack would maintain the same speed as that ship. All right. Next step. It may not give us... it's going to give us one. It's just going to take time. It's really kind of slow. Let's see what happens if we come over here. Nothing. All right, so we're going to go ahead and just progress on our own a little bit. To replenish hydrogen and oxygen at the survival kit, you need power. A working conveyor connection between the H2O2 generator as well as a survival kit and ice in the H2O2 generator. Replenish your oxygen and hydrogen at the survival kit. Well, if we come over here, you'll see we can't. If you look down there, you'll see that the O2 and the H2 in the lower left-hand corner isn't going up. So we have to fix that. One of the ways we can do that is by coming over here and fixing this right here. So the thing that, I mean, it's going to tell you, I'm just kind of advancing a little bit. If we come over here and we click on that, it'll add the components to the build planner. And if we hit the G key, we can open up the build menu right here. And in the lower right hand corner, you can see the G planner, or I'm sorry, the build planner. You'll see that it says conveyor tube and three small steel tubes, six motors, and four interior plate is what we need in order to complete the build on this. We'll come over here, go to our container, and we're going to hit the middle mouse button. All right, and we got all the components. Let's open up our inventory by hitting the I key. You can see three small steel tubes, four interior plates, and six motors. We can come over here now and complete that right there. Now we can come over here and replenish our O2 and H2. And if you look in the lower left-hand corner, you'll see it's all at 100%. Good job. Put oxygen bottles inside the H2O2 generator to refill them. So the oxygen bottles are already there. Many blocks like doors, button panels, consoles, medical rooms, inventories, and cockpits support various different actions. Press F to activate the highlighted block, which we already did. Press K to go to the menu, right? So we'll hit K. This opens up our terminal access and goes to the control panel. And the control panel shows you all your different blocks, with the exception of armor blocks. And it also gives you options. So you can toggle blocks on and off, whether or not they show up in this terminal, whether they show up in the toolbar configuration. You can name them. There's a ton of stuff you can do, and each block is kind of different, right? So this is a button panel. If we highlight the cargo container, you'll see options go away, but some options stay the same. And it's kind of like that throughout the game and throughout the different and various blocks. All right, and then finally, if we just come over here and we hit I, we'll open up the inventory right here so we can see the inventory of the cargo container as well as our own inventory. And up here, if we hit this show connected inventories, we could see all the things that have an inventory that are connected to this cargo container. In this case, our survival kit, our O2H2 generator, and our cargo container are all shown. And we can see we got ice, O2, and H2 in that ship. So we can pull that out or we can leave it in there. It doesn't matter. All right, moving on to the next step. These skills will serve you well. Build control panels to easily access ship menus. So you can basically build these control panels right here, separate of any box. If you hit a box behind a wall or something like that and you want to get to it, then you could build that control panel on a wall or something like that. A welder is used to construct and repair blocks by adding the required components from your inventory. Hold left mouse button to use the welder on any block. Well, we'll just come over here and just go bing. See, not any block. It took that one, so we did it. Impressive, most impressive. You can use the right mouse button to store components from your inventory into the block under construction. I've never done that. So we're gonna do that now, right? So we're gonna come over here. We're gonna pick this block right there. Come up here, grab some parts. Yeah, see, it does it. It stores it in the build planner. So that's what it's talking about. So I don't know why. You see what I mean? Like, it's a little confusing. Let's open up our build planner here and do that. All right, so it gave us all the hints and tips and blah, blah, blah. So let's come up here. We're gonna hit this control panel up here again. All right, these solar panels generate power when in contact with sunlight. This power is stored in batteries. Repair the solar panel to generate more power. You can find tools and components in the cargo container on the platform. Use your welder to repair this solar panel. All right, so as discussed before, we're gonna right mouse click to grab all the components that we need. Come over here, a middle mouse button to get them all out of the inventory. Run back up here and weld it up. And I am sorry that this sound is so loud. When we get to the mining, I'm actually gonna cut that part out. I'll just explain to you what was done so you don't have to hear the loud, obnoxious drill mining through the ground. Boom, so that part is complete. Next up is mining. So we're gonna come down here, we're gonna grab this right here. Press F. You can find ore inside asteroids and planets. Equip your drill to enable HUD markers that show you nearby locations of ore. So we're gonna equip our drill right here. And if we walk over here, you can see it says gold, iron, and ice. Locate drill and pick up some iron ore. So we're going to come over here. Now this part I am going to not put in the video because the drill is awfully loud if you're not using a mod to quiet it down. And Keen did not ingratiate us with options to, you know, just lower the volume of tools, right? You get music, you get sound, and you get chat, and that's it. Everything else, you kind of on your own. So I'm going to cut this part out, but rest assured, when you do this, you'll complete the step. All right, we're back. We completed the step. It said superb. You can put this iron ore in a basic refinery. A hand drill is used to break down rock, collect materials, or to dig tunnels. Ores can be found in asteroids and dark spots on planets. All drills are equipped with a short-range detector. Hold left mouse button to break down stone. Press F to pick up stones and hold right mouse button to quickly dig tunnels. All right, so for this step right here, what you're going to have to do is to get the press F to pick up rocks to complete. You're going to have to dig. And I am sorry, so please lower your volume for this point right here. But you're going to have to dig and then hold the F key at the same time. Right? And pick up enough stone. To fill up your inventory.
Grateful.
And as you can see, it didn't complete. It's kind of buggy the way it works. We're going to come over here. If you hold down the Alt key and hit your middle mouse button, you can throw all of that stuff in this inventory. So we can go over here and try it again. All right, it let us complete that step finally. All right, and then finally hold right mouse button to dig, to quickly dig tunnels. With right mouse button, rocks don't drop or ore doesn't drop or whatever. So we can come over here. And if I hold down the left mouse button, you'll see all these rocks dropped. If I hold down the right mouse button, you can see we're digging and there are no blocks dropping. Or rocks, I'm sorry, not blocks. Ah! Anyway, moving on to the next section. Come down here. And we're going to press F on this task right here. And read what it says. This ship is locked to the platform with magnetic landing gear. Find a way to unlock the landing gear through the consoles or use your grinder to destroy it. Note that turning it off will not unlock it. Disable the landing gear. So it doesn't tell you how to use a console. No step prior to this has told us how to use a console. And if we look around, you'll see there's no other steps around here, right? No little orange markers. So, sure, we can grab our grinder and we can start grinding away on this landing gear, but what does it mean to use the console? Well, I'm going to show you. If we come over here and we highlight the number 2 and then we hit the K key, we open up this toolbar configuration menu, and this is just all the components that are attached to this grid. We want the landing gear. So we're going to left click and drag down into spot 2. And we want that to be unlock or switch lock. Now, if you were going to, I don't know, do your own playthrough in survival and you set this type of thing up, you might want to do lock and then set up another button for unlock or switch lock. So you can do different things. As you can see on this panel, we have 4 buttons. So we could do pretty much anything we want. So I'm going to set up a lock, an unlock, and a switch lock. Now, switch lock is a single button that allows you to lock and unlock the landing gear. So it's just one button. When it's green, it's locked. When it's yellow, it's ready to be locked. And if it's white, it means that there's nothing next to it that can lock onto it. So we have it in a ready to lock state here. So now we can hit the lock button here and it'll lock. And of course we have unlock. So it's all about what you want to do. If you need to save space on a button panel, or if you need to save space on your own hotbar, then you might want to use switch lock instead of both of them. All right, your energy is getting low. Interact with a powered medical bay or survival kit to recharge your energy. So let's go over here. Recharge our energy and our oxygen real fast. And we're going to move on to the next part of the tutorial. And actually may have already put it up. So to find out if it put it up, we're going to hit F1. And we're going to go to Goodbot Chat. And it did not put it up. All right, so there we go. Energized. Your energy drains faster when it is hot or cold. So when it's cold outside, your energy drains faster. If it's hot outside, your energy drains faster. And when it's warm, your energy drains at its normal drain rate. And you can tell by looking underneath the toolbar on the right-hand side. You'll see where it says freeze in red and O2 in red. That's how you know. A grinder is used to deconstruct and salvage blocks by removing their components into your inventory. Hold left mouse button to use grinder on any block. Well, what block would we want to cut down? You know what? Let's just grind this one down. Maybe. There we go. Let's build it back up since we destroyed it. All right. You make quick work of that. Grinders can be used to remove trees as well. I have done that. Next step, please. See, it's being slow again. Not giving me my next step. Hello? Mr. Goodbot? Well, I can tell you what the next step is because I've done this tutorial twice now, preparing for this video. The next step is you're going to climb onto your ship right here. You're going to open this door, and you're going to close this door. And you're going to open this door. All right? This is an airlock. It's designed to keep oxygen from flowing from one area throughout into space. Or, you know, wherever you don't have oxygen. Ow! If you stand in the door, you'll get smacked with it. Alright, you're hurt. You can heal by interacting with a console of a medical bay. Blah, blah, blah. So we come over here. Do that. And you saw all that air blowing out of there? That's because I left it open. Why is it getting dark over here? The sun is moving, that's why. Alright, so we replenished our health. There we go. Can we just move on to the next step? I'm telling you, I didn't miss it. Let's see here. Grinders, Goodbot, hand drill. We went through all the parts. I'm not sure why it's not showing this part, but what we're going to do is we're going to close these doors. Alright. It says you will slowly heal. Okay, now we're moving on. A ship requires thrusters for movement, gyroscopes to orient, power, and a cockpit. The controls for a ship are the same as the jetpack. Press Y to toggle the power on and off. If you look over on the right-hand side of the UI, you'll see it says Y and then has a little power emblem. If we do that, we're turning the power off. Press C and space to go up and down. You can only do that if there's power. So if I press it right now, and I'll hit the key pretty hard so you can hear. Well, maybe not. But anyway, you can't move without power. So we're going to hit Y again, turn our power back on. Hey, and we're going to move up, and we're going to go down. I want to move out of the way a little bit, and we're going to use the A and D key for that, and we can roll as well, and there you have it. If we hit V, we can go into third-person view. This is normally how I fly my ships. Pilots take a special joy in walking. Pilots like flying. Pilots take no special joy in walking. Pilots like flying. Neil Armstrong. You need thrusters in all six directions. More thrusters means faster acceleration. But there is a top speed, and it's 100 meters per second for a ship and 110 meters per second for your jetpack. And ladies and gentlemen, that pretty much concludes this tutorial. We're gonna get this bad boy right here locked back up. Let's get in here like that right there. You know what I mean? Oh, let's look at it. This is why you gotta go in a third person when you're flying. There we go. Oh, it's sweet. I love it when a plan comes together. We're gonna get out right here and do that. We're not quite close enough, but you know what? It'll be fine. It'll be fine. You see it's white right there? It means we can't connect. So let's get back over here. The last inner chipmunk show longer to figure this out. Do not jump. I'm going to talk about the magnetic boots. And it's all because this tutorial is meant to be played all at one time. But we're not going to do that. Because we are... Alright, we're up against it. Now we can get out of our pilot seat. Oh, what? Ah, there we go. Sometimes you just don't connect to the floor. Oh, come on. There we go. Yeah, we're locked back up. Hey, watch that thruster. It'll burn you. And we can go back in here. Hit Y, turn everything off, and then we won't get burned by that thruster, will we? However, you cannot hit that. You cannot close that. So, what did we learn today? We learned how to operate the tutorial, and that was basically it. But, as you saw, there was a step or two that just kind of wasn't in the tutorial that new players just might not figure out. So that's what this tutorial was about. It was about helping them figure it out. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye, everyone.